if you try, you wouldn't understand. Hi, welcome back. My name is Bethany. I'm a wife and mom of four. I am in my bathroom, clearly, and I am getting dressed. It's actually only 12 o'clock, but we are going to the Nate Bargatze comedy tour tonight, and I'm so excited about it. But I'm gonna have to get makeup and everything done now because we have reservations with some new friends at 5:15. My husband is working today, but he has someone coming in and taking his shift, but he doesn't know when they're gonna be there. So they might be there at like 4, they might be there at 4:30. And then him having to come all the way home, getting dressed, and then going. I won't have any time to get dressed then. So that's what I'm gonna do now. My older kids are on fall break. My 3-year-old is at school, and then my baby is napping right now. So that's what I'm gonna take now to do. And with his humble lack and everlasting ego, someone hurt your feelings not that long ago. Got my makeup on. I went a little heavy on it because it's gonna be this evening. And we're just going out. So I just be heavy. So now I'm gonna do my hair. I don't know what's going on. Like I am like breaking out so bad. Does not handle change very well, and so I'm trying to use up some like products that I have that I've had for a while. I'm just trying to use them up and get rid of them. And so I used up one container of moisturizer, and then I switched, and now I'm breaking out again. So, but like after I was done, I haven't gotten breakouts in years, because I was pregnant and breastfeeding. I feel like that really helps your skin, or at least it did for me. And so I was basically back to back for 3 years, and then once I stopped breastfeeding my baby, I just looked like I was a teenage girl from the 90s, because teenagers these days, they don't really have to deal with a whole lot. They look way different than what we went through, or what I went through. Anyways, I finally feel like I kind of found a good cleanser and routine for my skin, but I have noticed throughout the years that if I every time we move, or we go on vacation or whatever, the different things in water, it'll affect it. And then if I change a product or whatever, it just affects it. So that's just what I'm having to go through. But yeah, so I'm so excited about tonight. We are going to Nate Bargatze. If you guys aren't familiar with him, you guys need to look him up. He's hilarious. So I'm really, really excited about that. And me and my husband, we've been trying for about a year now. The first couple months last year were rough. But we're really trying once a month, taking time out for ourselves as a couple, as a married couple, and doing a date night. I know some people do weekly. We just can't manage that with schedules and everything. So we are doing monthly date nights, and we're rotating it. Both of our parents live close to us. They're willing to help. So 1 month we'll have my parents, and then the next month will be his parents, and then we have a babysitter too. So we'll rotate it between the three of them. And so far, it's worked out really well. I know sometimes it can get difficult with, budget. Last month, we were date night, and it was, we just weren't hungry. We were going to go to an Italian restaurant, but we just were not feeling it, and so we ended up just going to this kind of a fast food restaurant. It was called Salad and Go. It opened up near us. So we just went there, and we had a little mini date night, and you know, if it's that, something that fits more like in budget, then you know, just do that, or make a dessert, you know, just sit on the back patio, drink some wine or beer or whatever it is. But it's really, it's been really, really good to take that time out. Since I had my last child, I have been really trying to focus, you know, on myself and spruce up my wardrobe, spruce up my look, trying to, I really just put myself on the back burner. I think I just like forgot how to even do my makeup. I was working full time, you know, and waking up at 5 o'clock and going into work, and I felt really lazy with it. I just threw on some foundation, not really thinking of it, and that's kind of what I got used to. So, you know, it's kind of funny, you know, 37-year-old woman trying to watch Instagram reels or YouTube on how to do your makeup, how to curl your hair, like, just having to, like, kind of relearn everything. And then also with pregnancy and breastfeeding, and then also my surgery, too, I haven't really bought a lot of new clothes for myself. I've just always focused on the kids and, like, their needs, but now that they're not changing the wardrobe out every 3 months, and they can last a lot longer. It's kind of time to kind of spruce up my wardrobe. So, speaking of that, it's been fun. Like, in high school, really long ago, they had like awards like your senior year, and I think my husband got like class clown, but I got a dress, and you would never be able to tell nowadays, but it's something that I've always loved, and I've kind of lost that along the way, and so now just kind of getting back into like something that you have enjoyed in the past is just kind of nice. Speaking of that, I had an outfit in mind for tonight, and I got so excited, so I went to Goodwill looking for something, and I came across this leather skirt, and I was so excited, and so I bought it for tonight, and it just not working. So luckily I tried it on earlier, like during the weekend, so I went out and I went shopping, bought a whole bunch of stuff, and I came home and tried it all on. So I gotta show you what I got, or what I'm gonna wear tonight. And it's so cute. And I saw this one thing that was like, once, you know, postpartum mom or like a new mom finds like their style again, it's like the sexiest thing ever. And it's so true, because it's just like, once you like find that confidence, like you can just see it in that person, and that's kind of like how I feel. But my husband was picking out his clothes last night, and I'm probably gonna have to spruce up his wardrobe as well, or focus on that. So, anyways, I'm gonna lay out my clothes for the night. I'm not gonna change into them, I'm just gonna lay them out, and I'm gonna show you what I got, or what I'm gonna wear, and then we'll just do a couple errands.
This thing on the stool because I'm short. But I got this jacket a couple months ago. It's like my son's baseball team's color and going to be his basketball team color. So I was like, oh, perfect. I'll be able to wear this for like baseball games and then basketball games. And I hadn't worn it yet. So I'm going to wear that tonight. It's going to be warm here in Oklahoma. So I originally had like a sweater and I was afraid I was going to get too hot. So this is what I came up with. This is one of the Amazon body suits that I got a while ago. And it's a short sleeve one, the Mango Pop. It's really comfortable. And then I'm so excited. I've been looking for like this kind of wash in black. And I got these at Walmart. So I got these. They're really long. They have like a slit right here. So I was going to cut these, but both my husband and my son was like, no, don't cut them. And they look pretty cute. And then these, I'm so excited about these. These are from Target and they are so cute on. I think these were 8s. So I went down a size in these, but they are adorable. So that's what I'm going to wear for tonight. And then this from the Prime Days. So I don't know if I'm going to wear this or if I'm just going to wear like a regular clutch or something, but anyways, I thought that was super cute. So that's gonna be my outfit, and then I'll show you the final look once, you know, I get dressed this evening.
I'm in the laundry room now. I'm gonna make the soccer treats. We normally have soccer on Saturdays, but they have a week off because everyone's on fall break. So she's bringing snacks a week from tomorrow. But I've already bought all this stuff, so I'm just going to go ahead and make those. I bought the bags, black, just their plain black bags from Amazon. And then I went and I got the ribbon from Hobby Lobby. She's not like on a like a team, I guess. It's pretty like for beginners. It's a league that like everyone has like the same jerseys. They're like reversible, and so one side is red, one side is black, and so they tell us what sides wear. Year doing it, and my oldest is doing flag football through them, and then my 3-year-old is doing t-ball through them. So it's been really good. She likes doing, of course, Gatorade. So I got a little thing from Sam's, and then applesauce, Cheez-Its, and then her favorite candy is Smarties. So I'm putting those in there, and then I'm just tying them with the ribbon. So, getting that all done. I don't even know how many of them are a team. I'm guessing like 9. That would probably be the easiest to wait to do this, but you know, I just want to get off the list. So that's what I'm gonna do. Let's do that.
I guess it never hit you. Our conversation takes two. Paying it some interest from time to time. Inside all that greatness.
So right now I am just laying out their clothes. I like to do this on Fridays. I used to do it on Sundays, but it just got to where it was like I just always ran out of time, and they were like hustling Sunday evening or even Monday to do it. So Fridays I'm off work, and so that's whenever I like to get it done. My 3-year-old, he is in school part-time, and they have free dress on Fridays, but they have,
dress code on like Mondays and Wednesdays, and I hate it. I absolutely hate it. But we like the reason why we went there is because we love the teacher, but still don't like the dress code. So colored shirts, and like solid color. We kind of bent the rules a little bit. Not supposed. And this is why I lay them out. So this is for my 3-year-old. His clothes fit a little bit better in this. I've had this for years, probably 10 plus years. And then I bought this one. It's a little bit bigger because my 7, almost 8-year-old has bigger clothes, especially like for sweaters and stuff. So I bought this for him a couple years ago, and this has worked out wonderfully. I used to have like labels on here so they could help themselves, but these fell off. But anyways. That's what we do for them, and I'm going to finish laying up the boys' clothes, and I'm going to move into the girl, or Audrey's. I don't lay out our baby's clothes because she's home with us, but anyways, I'm going to do this. With his humble lack and everlasting ego. Even if you try, you wouldn't understand it. Maybe something's missing inside of you. Just a bit of put their clothes away on Thursdays, and this is how my son just threw them in here. I guess I can't really complain because at least they're doing chores. But anyways, I had to show you this and how he did that.
He's still sleeping. So we are on to my daughter's closet. Both Monday and Tuesday next week as well. So, some of these clothes that I have picked out, they're probably not gonna wear the lawyer, something a little bit more comfortable, which is fine. But I also have one for her clothes. I probably need to get a bigger one because she's, you know, getting to that point. But let's pick out some clothes for her. I guess it never hit you. Our conversation takes two, paying it some interest from time to time. Inside all that greatness and all of your adventures. That is all done. My kids do chores. I try to teach them to like their new clothes put on one side of the closet so I'm not picking like the same clothes every week. We're still working on that. Like I said, I gotta be happy that they're at least doing their chores. So what we have found that works out really well for us so far is that every day they have like one chore. And so like on Tuesdays it's take out the trash, or maybe like wipe down the stairs, or clean the toilets. What's something else? Feed and water our dog. Put their clothes away. My daughter likes to put the clothes like in the washer. So, and then we have like what we call like payback chores. And so we have chores like pull weeds or load the dishwasher or whatever, and they get money for those chores. So they have to do their chores. They have to do all of their chores that week. And then if they do extra chores, then they get money. Actually worked out really well for us. I think we finally found something that works and that we're sticking to, because that was the problem, is that we just weren't sticking to that. But so anyways, like I was saying, I have to be happy that they're actually doing something or doing their chores and kind of getting that responsibility and learning about that, and trying to let go of my control and maybe it not being the way that I like for it to be done. But at least they're getting it done. So I gotta be happy about that. So we're gonna go clean our bathroom really quick.
We're back in the bathroom. I'm trying to clean the tub. We painted pumpkins the other day, and my baby got black paint all over her, and then like whenever I gave her a bath,
mother-in-law is coming over to watch the kids while we're going to a comedy show. I am going to make sure that this is clean, try not to get distracted and get everything done that needs to get done for her, and try not to get distracted on other things. So I'm going to clean this, and then I'm going to go ahead and hurry up and prep dinner. So all she has to do is like put it in the oven. And then pick up around the house, and if I have time for other stuff, that'd be perfect. But this, I've been using this for ever since 2020. This is the perfect cleaner for like water stains and bathtubs, showers, like to get like your glass clean. It is just baking soda and then Dawn dish soap to make a paste, and then just like a little bit of water. So this is what I've been using for about 3 years, and really, I have, we've had glass in our showers ever, you know, ever since we've been in the house, and I can never figure out how to get, like, those water stains out, and then I found this, and it's worked wonders. So, I made this, and I haven't gone back. So, just FYI, this stuff works really well.
Inside all that greatness and all of your adventures,
chore done, but baby's up now, so let me show you how this bathtub turned out. I should have done this last night because that paint kind of stuck a little to the sides, but let me show you.
So well, you can't even see any like black speckles on the tub, but anyway, yeah, you should really try that baking soda and Dawn dish soap if you're having troubles with
soap. Baby's up now. My almost 8-year-old is giving me attitude, but they're outside, so I am going to prep dinner for my mother-in-law. They're just having sliders tonight. And so, got Hawaiian rolls, and I'm probably going to have to refresh my memory on how long these go in the oven and what the topping is. But you just cut these in half, and then I put mayo on them. And I've been doing this for, I've been really struggling with lunches, and one thing that my kids like is these sandwiches for lunches, and I've seen like on Instagram and stuff where you can put them in the freezer and they'll be good like by their lunch time, and so I've been doing that and they really like them, so that's a win. And then I'm also, I was having it going to do peanut butters, and so it'll help my husband out as well in the morning whenever he has to pack their lunches. So I'm just spreading mayo on. I went to the store this morning. I have more, they like this cheese better, but I have a lot of problems. So I'm gonna do one side of Colby Jack and then one side of Provolone. And hopefully that will be okay. And then they also, they say they like turkey better, but I don't think they really know what they like. And so I am just doing chicken. I did buy turkey, but that will also work whenever I make it for their lunches. So I'm just gonna put that on top. This will be something for my mother-in-law to just pop in the oven really quick. Kids tend to eat it. Sometimes it can be hit or miss with the babies, but they can always do like chicken fries or whatever if she can't get them to eat this. Then I normally do like butter. I can't remember what other. A little bit of mustard. I'm not sure. I can't remember. I need to refresh my memory on that. So, if you are, and that's one thing about like, you know, date nights and babysitters and stuff, is that you still kind of plan for your kids to eat. So sometimes, you know, it's a lot of work. Yeah.
so do I. You can only have frozen pizzas so often before you just need to take a break from it. And we are kind of at that point. We are needing to take a break from pizza. So we do some things that we have done, and like you also don't want it to be like too hard for like a babysitter, especially. You know, parents are just a lot easier. You just don't have to worry about like time and being out too late or being late in general. You can just kind of enjoy yourself a little bit more. So we try, like, whenever we do have the babysitter, we try to do like the closer activities or the things that we want to do. And then whenever we have like a parent watching the kids, then we'll go and like actually make reservations somewhere. So anyways, is anyone else like that, or is that just us? But things that we have done to help a like babysitter or even grandparents is that we've done these sliders, we've done pizza, we've done pigs in the blanket, which my kids really like that, just hot dogs and croissant rolls, obviously like pasta of any kind is good. So I'll just have like a thing of butter on the side and a brush, and she can brush it on, and then I'll have the instructions. And these will just go in the oven. I also have some pre-made cookies if they want. I might go ahead and make this. I'm not sure. We'll see. Anyway, so the kids are being really good outside. I need to. This house is just a mess. I still have clothes I need to put away, wipe down counters. So that's what I'm going to do. And I think I might call it for the end of this video. So thank you so much for watching, and get it done while baby sleeps video, and I'll catch you next time.